You all know what it's like to be called heartless, but thankfully it's only been said to you in the figurative sense, when you did something like take the last M&M from the packet. But can you imagine what it would be like to be literally heartless, like to have an empty space where your heart used to be? You might be thinking right now that this is not possible, but you'd be wrong to assume that. We know that because these words were spoken by a US teen who lost her heart for a few months. It was like I was a fake person, like I didn't really exist, I was just there. Yeah, she didn't much enjoy her time without her vital organ. We'll get to her miraculous story soon, but first let's give you a rundown on how science has tried to fix the problem of living without a heart. We hate to state the obvious, but we should let you all know that some hearts work better than others. That's not always because of age or lifestyle or even disease. Some people are just born with what are called congenital heart defects. Sometimes a bad heart needs to be replaced, so we have a thing called a heart transplantation. The problem is there just aren't enough hearts to go around. We're going to point out the obvious here again and tell you that donors aren't alive and well and decide to give up their hearts. What happens is someone who is declared brain dead or on a ventilator and had before this downfall agreed to donate his or her heart, they'll have their heart removed and it can go to someone who needs it. The problem is there are thousands of folks just in the US on the waiting list. There are a lot of dodgy trickers in the world, as the British might put it, and not enough donors. If a lucky person is lucky enough to get a new heart, that transplanted heart would have to have been a good match. Usually the donated heart has to be transplanted within about 4 to 6 hours, and there's always a chance the living person's body might reject the heart. That's pretty selfish of the body, but hey, it's picky about who it lives with. We won't go into too many details because this is not necessarily a heart transplant story. What happened to the teen in the US is way more incredible than merely having a heart transplant. But first, you need to know why. You see, because so many people need transplants and there's not enough hearts to go around, science has been trying to make what are called artificial hearts. As you can guess, that's not an easy thing to do. In the 1960s, the National Institute of Health created an artificial heart program. During that decade, partial mechanical hearts were put into young cows, and for a while the calves were fine, but after a few months they were dead. That didn't bode well for the heart-needy humans, of course. In 1969, a man in the US went 64 hours with a pneumatic-powered artificial heart inside of him, but then 32 hours later, he was dead. This replacing hearts business was very tricky indeed. It was in 1981 that a dentist from Seattle got the green light from the FDA to have a full artificial heart implanted. He survived 112 days, but all the time he was fastened to a huge compressor that pumped air into him. This was not a good time for the man, and he actually asked to die while he was hooked up to the machine. His mental and physical state for most of the ordeal was terrible. Things improved and artificial hearts got somewhat better, but the chances of living to a ripe old age with an artificial heart is still off the cards. Think about it. The real heart is a busy organ and it must pump blood around the body nonstop, and it must do that job to perfection. It can't take time off like the rest of the body. It's finely tuned, perfect for most of us. When hearts start skipping beats or decide to take a break, or maybe they go overboard with the pumping action, the person who owns them generally does the hand-on heart and fall to the floor routine. Getting it right is hard. And as one doctor put it, creating a workable artificial heart has become the holy grail for researchers. So we have a situation in which an artificial heart might keep a person going for a while, but it's only supposed to be a bridge before that person can get a heart transplant. Some people have to wait a long time, and those artificial hearts in some cases don't do the job. People died before they got the transplant. It was only in the last decade that some people led pretty normal lives with a temporary artificial heart. They weren't confined to a hospital and didn't have to plug themselves into massive compressors. In 2015, there were cases of people getting artificial hearts and they just had to carry around with them a battery and an air pump that could fit in a backpack. It was noisy, though, which could really get a person down when the pumping sound was 24/7, and anyone close also had to hear it. There are other dangers too. One guy who got one of those machines said while getting ready for a sponge bath, he accidentally knocked over the compressor and then the battery stopped working, and that meant that his heart stopped working and he fell to the floor ready to die. Luckily, the backup battery had his back and his fake heart resumed activities. The problem with that is the constant worry that the thing will malfunction and also having to remember to keep those batteries charged. A dead battery means a dead person, and being hooked up to the valve and a compressor all day takes its toll on a person's spirit. It's also high-risk odds. Sure, having an artificial heart beats death any day of the week, but some people even fairly recently have died soon after the device was implanted. One French recipient of an artificial heart got home after 5 months in the hospital. In an interview, he told the French newspaper, "I have completely recovered. I can walk, I can get up, and I can bend down 10 to 15 times a day without any difficulty. In fact, I have never felt so good." And the guy died shortly after the interview. Okay, we might have taken some time to get around to the US teen who lived with no heart at all, not even an artificial one. But if you didn't know the backstory, her story wouldn't mean that much to you. So her name is Dejana Simmons, and in 2008, when she was 14 years old, she got out of a hospital with a new heart. Her original heart had become enlarged, and so it had to go. The girl would have died from that condition. Her story is special because the doctor said she was one of a kind. Okay, a German man survived with absolutely no heart, but he was the only one until Dejana came along, so she was the first child to go fully heartless. She said it was scary and she never knew if the machine was just going to malfunction, so talk about putting your trust into a device. The girl had actually had a heart transplant in the past, but that first heart didn't take and she had to wait for another. Doctors explained that with other cases, such as ones we've talked about today, the person's heart is left in the body. Sure, in the stories we've talked about, people have been given a new artificial heart, but with Dejana, she had the whole thing removed and was kept alive by pumps connected to only blood vessels. What happened was called a big deal in medical science, since it was the first time it ever happened to a child. The head doctor told the press it had never been done in a pediatric patient. Dejana herself said she was kind of a miracle child. After a time without a heart, she crossed the bridge and got a new heart, and this time it was the right fit. She might need to replace it one day, but she seemed to be living well the last time the media talked about her. Now, you must be in the mood to hear about another miracle, and so we have the perfect story for you. Take a look at this incredible video. She fell 10,000 feet and survived 11 days in the rainforest. And if that's not to your liking, have a look at this one. Either way, they're both great stories.